Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have how to plump up your lips a little bit and make them look a little bit fuller. Number one, if you are clicking on this video because you want to see the Kylie Jenner kind of spin on it, I'm not going to be doing that. I'm not going to be sucking on any type of jar or doing a challenge for you guys. If you guys suck on a jar to get your lips a little bit plumper, then go right ahead. I'm not judging anyone or bashing on anyone. I'm just saying that's not what you're going to find in this video. I'm just going to be sharing with you guys how I like to make them look a little bit more fuller without getting lip fullers or injections or anything like that. And this is the most safest route, and I'm not going to be doing anything harmful. So if you guys want to see it, then stick around. Alright guys, so to begin, I'm only going to be using a few simple products. I do have a pretty full set of lips. I know my bottom is a little bit bigger than my top. My top is my struggle area where it's a little bit flatter, and I would like it to just look a little bit more oomphed up. So that's where I kind of plump it up just a little bit in that area. So this is going to be the alternative version of getting those lip fillers or lip injections, and no judging or hating on anyone that has them because I kind of want them. But anyway, these are just going to be the things that I'm going to be using and how I like to do it. So to begin, you want to make sure that your lips are nice and hydrated and not chapped, because chapped lips is very unattractive, and especially for this step and process and making them look a little bit fuller, you don't want to have dry, crusty lips because it draws more attention. So I'm going to be putting on some lip balm. I'm going to be doing just a little bit since we are applying a little bit more product on top of it. So I'm going to be putting on some chapstick or a lip balm, whatever you prefer. And this one is by LUSH. It's actually my favorite so far. It's the None of Your Beeswax lip balm. And I just find it to be super hydrating. I wear it every night before bed, and I think that it worked a ton. So I love it. And it's about to start thundering and raining out right now. So sorry if you hear that, because I didn't even know it was going to do that. Anyway, so you just want to make sure that your lips are super hydrated and ready to go. But first I'm going to be using a lip liner to kind of draw out my lips. Now today I'm going to be using the Laura Geller Pout Perfection lip liner. And this is just a pink shade. Very nude and natural. So I'm going to be taking my lip liner, and you want to make sure that it is sharpened. So I always start with the top lip first, and like I said, you don't want to make it look like they're very unnatural. So what you're going to do is you're going to keep this section, the two corners, your natural lip. You're going to line it to the natural corner of your lip. And this part up here is where you're going to make it look a little bit more fuller. But you also don't want to look like a clown, so you want to keep it very subtle. So I'm going to start out by doing the corners, and then I'll show you what I mean once I'm done. And this actually matches my lip color, so sorry if you can't really see it, but that's the exact reason why I like it, is because it's not too dramatic and it's my lip color. So if you have any edges that got messed up, you can use your finger to kind of clean up that area. Is just bring it up just a tad. And connect it to my natural Cupid's bow, but a little bit higher, if that makes any sense. And then I'm going to fill in my lip. Basically, you just want to make sure that the bottoms and the corners of your top lip is matching up to your natural lip line. And then this is where you would begin to come up just a little bit over the hump and back down to your natural lip line. So now that the top is completed, I'm going to move on to the bottom. And it's pretty much the same exact method. I'm keeping the corners my natural and then bringing it just a little bit past my natural lip line. I really don't go too crazy, as you'll notice. I like to keep it still very subtle. So corner matches up, now I'm going to bring it a tiny, tiny bit past my natural lip line. Like just underneath it. And this will make it look a little bit bigger. And then I fill it in. So this is what it looks like when the lip liner is all completed. And then I'm going to go in with my NYX Wonder Pencil to clean up the area. Now you can use concealer, you can use this, anything like that to kind of just clean up your mistakes, clean up the lips a little bit, and make them look a little bit more sharp. If you're going the route of concealer, just make sure the concealer shade is not too light, because you don't want to brighten the area. You just want to simply hide anything that you might have mistaken or just clean up the area a little bit. So I'm going to do that. And before it's all finished, I'm sure you're seeing like a white line over there. I'm definitely going to be blending it out once I'm done. So don't worry, it's going to blend. To really define your Cupid's bow and make it appear a little bit more larger as well, you would go in with a highlighter or a shade like this, but this is also considered a highlighter. So I'm going to place it right in between and just define it a little bit more. So instead of applying a lipstick or a lip gloss, I'm actually going to be applying the Lip Injection by Too Faced to plump them up just a little bit more. And this is also going to add color as well, since it is a lip product like that. So it is in the shade Bee Sting, which is such a gorgeous light pink nude color. Oh my god, stunning. I love it. And with this product, you are going to feel some tingling on your lips, and it's going to might feel a little bit uncomfortable at first. If you're not into that, you might not want to wear it. You might just want to stick with this method and leave it at that. And I think this looks gorgeous like this, so you can just leave it like this. But I am going to do it in a little extra oomph and add this onto it. So it is going to sting and feel a little weird at first, but it does go away and it does add a beautiful color at the end. So I'm going to follow the shape that I already did, and once it is on, it takes a few seconds to a minute or so to kind of get the feeling on your lips, and then it'll start plumping up by itself. I'm just going to leave it like that, and this color matches perfectly to the lip liner that I use, so I love that fact. And yeah, it'll just take a few seconds to get a little bit juicier, and they're not going to be like, you know, huge lips or anything. If that's what you're expecting, it's not going to happen with this. So while that is happening, I'm going to highlight, and I actually feel it starting to tingle a little bit. And when you use it by itself on your natural lips, you'll feel it a lot more. But I do have a liner underneath, so it's not going to be as intense, but I feel it in my mouth. So to highlight, I'm going to be taking my Becca Moonstone highlighter. My favorite part of like anything, because that just kind of draws all the attention and it just looks super cute and complete. So I'm going to be taking my finger to do this step. You could use a fan brush or a smaller brush if you wanted to. I am going to be using my ring finger, putting a little bit of product on there and dabbing it onto the top of the Cupid's bow. And then you can blot down if you would like. And I'm gonna use my other finger to brush. But that's really it for what I do and how I like to overdraw them. I really don't go so crazy with it, but you can take these steps and make it into your own. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, maybe found it a little bit helpful. And I'm not bashing on anyone if you do have lip injections or if you wanna suck on a jar to get the plumper looking effects. It's all up to you guys. I'm just showing you how I like to do them and how I've been recently doing it. So if you guys enjoyed it, please give me a big thumbs up, because that helps me out a ton. And if you're not subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button wherever she is right now. I don't know. And I think that is it for this video. Until next time, I will see you in my next video. Bye! Packing.